menyelesaikan puzzle baru, yaitu Marslander episode 1. Kali ini kita akan menyelesaikan Marslander dengan Python. Nah, pasti kalian juga masih ingat dong ya, karena kan kemarin kalian udah menonton juga versi C#. Kita akan melakukannya sama aja gitu kayak gitu, tapi bedanya kali ini pakai Python. Kalian bisa lihat cuplikan di sini. Kayaknya Marslander episode 1 ini akan seru deh. Kan seru, aku bilang juga apa. Nah, di Marslander kali ini, episode 1 ini, kalian hanya harus mendaratkan roket kalian di tempat yang benar biar gak meledak gitu. Nah, kalian itu harus bermain dengan vertical velocity doang gitu, karena Marslander 1 ini kalian cuma harus mendaratkan roket secara vertikal gini doang. Kalian gak usah bermain angle-nya gitu, gak usah itu, kalian akan bermain di angle ini episode kedua. Seru kan? Kalau aku sih seru banget gitu ngeliat yang meledak-meledak gini gitu. Seneng banget, pengen banget nyelesain atau cariin solusinya gitu.
Yuk, siapa yang gak sabar untuk menyelesaikan puzzle di dalam Python? Langsung aja yuk, do it!
Hi everybody, nice to see you.
Oke, Koda Coding, hari ini kita akan melakukan Marslander versi Python.
Yeah. So, okay. You find it here in practice.
Yes.
And then classic puzzle, easy.
Kalian bisa menemukannya di practice. Puzzle easy.
Hiding somewhere. Here we are.
Here we are. Marslander.
Yes. It appears completely because we need C sharp. By the way, this will be like C sharp.
Yes.
So it's for people who don't do C sharp and do Python instead.
Yeah. Jadi biasanya kan kalau kalian coding Python, kalian itu cuma coding Python. Biasanya kalian tidak terlalu mengerti C sharp. Tapi kalau kalian yang coding C sharp, kalian pasti juga ngerti Python kan. Oke, jadi ini video ini khusus buat kalian yang ada yang cuma Python. Yeay!
Wonderful. Alright, so we will learn mainly conditions.
What will I learn? Conditions?
But we learned them already in the previous episode of Python.
Yeah. Jadi kita tuh dari segini banyaknya video yang udah kalian tonton gitu, dari video-video sebelumnya, kan kita kan selalu belajar tentang kondisi terus ya.
So we try to learn something more. Yes. Okay.
Yep.
Voila.
Yeah. Seperti yang bisa kalian lihat, kita pilih Python. Ya. Yang dimana di sana itu, di dalamnya dari coding game, kita sudah diberi code secara otomatik dari coding game.
Yes. So all these lots of code already came. Yeah. When you select Python 3, as you said. Yes. 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 Wonderful. And the green one, as we learned last time, our comments, yeah. Yes. So a lot of comments here.
Yeah. Jadi di sini itu banyak code yang tidak aktif, yang dimana kalian bisa lihat itu ada tanda pagar, lalu code-nya itu berubah jadi warna hijau, tandanya ini hanya comment yang dimana code-nya itu tidak aktif. Ya, kalau kalian hilangin tanda pagarnya, comment-nya berubah jadi aktif, oke? Okay? Ya, karena di sini itu kita punya banyak input, yang mana input-nya itu sebenarnya nggak terlalu terpakai semua ya. Oke, okay, let's see.
Yes. So, as always, input and output,
yes.
And yeah, as you said, I guess the input is the surface of Mars, the shape of it, we
yes.
don't care too much about it, the position of the rocket, mm-hmm. yes, and we give two outputs to yes. control the rocket.
Yes, jadi kita itu harus mengkontrol roket ini untuk mendarat itu dengan dua output ya, yang mana di sini ada angle And the other, the power.
Yes, perfect. Angle and
dan
power.
Power yang harus kita print di output ya.
Wonderful. Okay. Let's try it.
Yeah, let's try it.
Okay, so what is the output? This is input.
Yeah, this is the input.
Right, because it says it's input here, right?
Yeah.
Here. The output is this.
Yeah, this is. Yeah, ini adalah output yang dimana kalau pakai Python itu kita tinggal tulis aja print lalu kita masukin outputnya. Kalau di C# itu kan kemarin beda ya.
Perfect. So the first number is the rotation.
Rotation, power.
And power. Perfect. So let's try something. Let's try, for example, minus 90.
Wow.
And the maximum power, 4.
Yeah, jadi minus 90 ini angle-nya ya. Yang mana sih sebenarnya di episode 1 ini kita nggak perlu ubah-ubah angle-nya. Tapi sekarang kita coba nih, kita print pakai angle minus 90. Apa yang akan terjadi dengan roket kita? Oke, okay, let's start the game.
Boom. Yes. Yep. Here we are.
Nih, di sini ada kalian yang mana kalian itu yang mengontrol roketnya. Wow. Dia angle-nya jadi miring ke samping gitu.
We're doing well. Almost there. Ready to land.
Kita hancur. Kenapa? Karena code yang kita masukkan itu belum benar. Ya.
Perfect.
Okay, let's see the rules.
Yes. Also, let's see what happens. Yes, because we were saying minus 90 and 4. Yes, and let's see what happens. Yeah, you can go step by step like this. Yeah, after 1 second. Yes.
Yeah, jadi ada 32 kali update. Ya, yang mana di sini?
Yeah, so
dia pergi step by step.
Yeah, so these are the inputs we get about the position.
The first update.
Yes.
Jadi dari pertama kali update, kalian bisa lihat di console output. Sebenarnya ini juga console input dan output. Kalian bisa lihat di game information. Di situ ada game information tentang setiap update yang diberikan. Yeah.
Yeah. And so we see after 1 second. Yeah, this is 1 second.
Yeah.
We asked rotation minus 90, but yeah, we only got minus 15.
Jadi meskipun kalian minta, kalian ngeprint, kalian itu mau ganti angle-nya ke minus 90, tapi itu dari konsol ini di game information, setiap detik kalian itu mendapat informasi setiap step, jadi kalian itu nggak bisa langsung ke minus 90.
Ya, yeah, so after 2 seconds, minus 30,
lalu
after
lagi
3 seconds,
45,
minus 45,
jadi step by step untuk merubah angle.
Yeah. So slowly it goes up to 90. Yeah. And concerning the power, if we go back, yeah.
Di sini powernya.
Initial power is 0. We ask 4, and then after 1 second, the power is 1. Yeah. After,
yeah.
After 2 seconds,
lalu
the power
2,
is 2.
Gitu. Yeah. Jadi biarpun kita minta powernya itu 4, program di sini nggak langsung mindahin power ke 4, tapi step by step gitu di setiap update dia mengubahnya.
Perfect. So this is how it works. Wonderful. So as you said, let's read more about the rules. Yes.
Yep. Nah, jadi di sini itu kita ada aturannya nih ya, untuk mendaratkan roket itu nggak semacam kita mainin number aja gitu, tapi kita juga harus baca dulu. Di sini ada aturan yang harus kalian patuhi gitu biar kalian itu mendarat dengan selamat, biar berhasil. Alright. Let's see.
Perfect. So for example, you see here we have an example. Initially, we get an input, which is the surface of Mars.
Yeah.
Yeah, these are 6 points.
Yeah.
And here the points are flat. You see, the Y is always 500.
Yes.
And 6 points, why? Because here we have, you know,
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
6 points to describe. Yeah. But as they say, we can ignore for the moment in this episode 1.
Ya, jadi yang kayak udah aku jelasin tadi, kenapa kita bisa ignore? Karena di sini tuh sebenarnya kita dapat banyak input, tapi inputnya itu nggak semuanya kepake di episode 1 ini. Mungkin di episode kedua nanti, episode ketiga nanti, itu kan lebih susah levelnya. Kalian akan pakai semua input ini, tapi kali ini kita hanya main di angle dan power aja.
Wonderful. And then every second, yeah, we get information in this way with this string. Yeah, the position, the horizontal and vertical speed, and other information.
Yeah.
Yes, and then every second we get the update. Yeah. Here we see we are falling. Yeah. And the vertical speed, yes, is minus something when we are going down. Yeah.
Yeah.
So, perfect. Great. Let's try something else. Some other examples.
Yes.
Okay. We understand. Yeah.
Oke, jadi minus 90 ini kan angle-nya nggak benar ya, karena kalau kalian perhatikan, kita itu jatuhnya dari atas ke bawah secara vertikal doang nih. Jadi kita nggak usah mainin angle-angle-nya sih, sebenarnya kalian biarin aja 0, oke? Okay?
Yeah, okay. So they explain that we must always output 0 for the angle. Yeah, so let's start doing that.
Yep, kita taruh sekarang 0, yep. Nah, di sini kita taruh 0 sebagai angle, lalu kita taruh powernya itu 4 aja ya. Then yeah.
Let's see what happens. So the gravity is 3.7 and our rocket is 4, so more than the gravity. Yep. Yes, let's see what happens in this case. Mm-mm. So 0, angle, 4, power.
Nah, kalau misalnya kalian udah yakin, kalian tinggal test cases. Kalau misalnya kalian yakin ini jawabannya benar.
Yep. So initially we fall, but then we start to win on the gravity.
Ya, kalian bisa lihat ya, karena gravitinya itu tadi 3.7.
So looks like we're going the wrong direction.
Kita malah makin naik ke atas. Sebenarnya kalian itu udah benar karena memasukkan angle-nya itu 0, tapi kalian itu masih salah karena powernya itu tidak belum sesuai, ya. Roketnya malah naik ke atas daripada turun ke bawah.
Failure. Mars lander is lost in space.
Oh my god.
So we see that the vertical speed was positive because we are going up.
Yes. Yep.
And at the beginning, at the very very beginning, instead, the vertical speed was negative because we're falling, but then the rocket, you know, was on and then we started to go up. Okay, wonderful. So clearly, we must put 0 and 4 always is too much, right?
Yep.
So let's try a different number.
Okay, sekarang kita coba 3 mungkin? 3? Oh, 0. Alright.
Oh, no.
Okay.
Let's try 0. You have to try for you, tell me.
Okay.
So, let's try 0. Yes?
Okay.
Boom.
Nah, so, ini kalau misalnya powernya 0, begini nih jadinya. Kita nggak nyalain rocket sama sekali.
Oh.
Ah!
Almost perfect landing, yes, because
karena dia turun ke bawah, tapi roketnya itu nggak kita hidupkan, jadinya so, nggak ada kekuatannya gitu.
So everything looked perfect, but the speed was a bit high. Yeah, that was the only thing, right? So let's see what it should be the maximum speed. So for a landing to be successful, the land must be flat, and that's we did it, yes. Yeah, we must arrive with an angle of 0. Yeah, we did it. Yeah.
Lalu vertikalnya, vertical speednya tuh harus nggak lebih dari 40 gitu. Sedangkan kita itu tadi vertical speednya -134. Wow, gede banget gitu. Nah, di sini ada batas vertical speed yang kalian nggak boleh abaikan, ya.
Perfect. So let's introduce this new rule. Yes, okay. In our code. Let's start to code.
Okay, sekarang kita langsung ke code. Yep, kita hapus aja dulu ini.
Let's learn something new. Because we keep Python and C# learning the same things, okay?
Yes.
So let's see how we can create a method.
Yep.
So basically, what we want to do is, this code is not clear what it does. You know, it's not very clear. So the best way is to give a description of this code.
Yeah.
To group the code in something called a method that describes what it does, yes?
Okay. Nah, kita di sini mau buat method. Kita kasih nama dulu. Okay.
And then when you group, yes, we always have to put 4 spaces, you know, here. And that means we group.
Yeah. Kalau di C# itu kan kemarin kalau kalian mau nge-group itu pakai curly bracket, tapi kalau di sini nggak perlu. Kalian cuma taruh aja spasi gitu ya.
And this definition doesn't do anything. But then when we call it, when we call the method, it does the job. Yes? It's perfect. Like we saw in the first lesson, yes. Where we saw step by step how the code runs, yes?
Yeah.
And then the same we can do here, because all we care is this vertical speed, yes?
Karena untuk sementara yang kita pedulikan itu hanya vertical speed. Okay, sekarang kita...
So here we read many things, but all we care is to get the vertical speed, right?
Yeah.
So get
vertical speed.
Yes. And...
kita kasih nama nih untuk grupnya.
So that's the grouping, yeah? And let's put it... here, and then we need to get this vertical speed, so we need to return the vertical speed. So this is a function, yes?
Yes.
Because it returns an information, yes.
Karena kalau method itu dia nge-return apa-apa, kalau function itu dia return something gitu ya. Di sini kan kita return vertical speed, berarti yang mana kita akan mendapat hasil dari vertical speednya itu gitu.
Perfect, wonderful. So let's see if we are going too fast. Yes, yes. Degree, that's something we need to know, because if we're going too fast, we have to do something.
Yep.
All right. So is
too fast.
This is Python. Is too fast.
Nah, kalau misalnya kemarin, kalau misalnya di C# itu kalian tinggal tulis aja is too fast tanpa underscore. Tapi kalau di Python ini kalian harus pakai underscore. Yang mana underscore ini kayak pengganti spasi gitu, kan sih?
So it's too fast if we go more than the maximum 40. Speed, which is 40. Yes, 40. So then we know we're going too fast, and we need to do something about it.
Yes.
But it's ugly to have a number like this because it's not very clear. So let's create something. Yeah. Max
speed.
Yes. Max speed equal 40. And then instead of 40 we put that.
Max speed. Yes.
So that is more clear.
Yeah. Jadi kalian itu kasih nama dulu tadi. Yang 40-nya itu, lalu kita bisa tinggal cantumin aja, daripada cantumin angkanya, kita bisa cantumin langsung variabelnya.
And then, because the vertical speed when we fall is negative, yes, then we put this minus in front of it, so it becomes positive, yes? Mm-hmm. Great! Okay, so now we have to put the famous condition.
Yes.
Yeah?
Tadi kan kita mau belajar tentang kondisi, lalu langsung aja yuk kita masukin kondisinya. If is too fast.
So if is too fast, we have to do something.
Yeah.
Well, what do we need to do? If it's too fast, we know what we need to do. We need to turn on the rocket.
The rocket.
Yeah.
Yes.
And a maximum power, because 3 is not enough. Yeah. Because the gravity is 3.7. So we know this must be 0, the angle.
Yeah.
And we know the power must be 4, because 3 is not enough to win the gravity.
Yes.
So in this way.
Karena gravitinya 3.7 gitu ya.
So if it's too fast, yes, then we turn rocket on. Otherwise,
do something else.
Do something else.
Maksudnya kayak lakukan hal sebaliknya dari kasus pertama tadi, gitu. Otherwise, turn rocket off.
Yes. So this must always be zero. We know it.
Yeah.
And if we are not going fast,
kita turn off the rocket. Okay. Yes.
So what do we do? We try it. What do you think?
Yes. Let's see. Okay, kita play test cases-nya. Okay, seperti yang
so bisa kita lihat,
dia jatuh ke bawah, lalu dia mulai menyalakan roket.
So you see here, sometimes it's 04, sometimes 00. 04, 00, 04, 00.
Berhasil! Congratulations!
Success!
Okay, kalian bisa lihat di game information.
So as we can see, at the end, the vertical speed was around 40, no more. Yes. And what we are doing is, you know, power maximum,
lalu
then off,
off maximum, lalu maximum off lagi.
Yeah. And in this way, we kept it around 40.
Yes.
So wonderful, yeah?
Woo!
So, let's see, we learned what is a method, we learned what is a function. Yes. And now let's learn something more about if.
Jadi daripada kalian menulis if seperti ini ada 4 baris, kita bisa membuat if ini lebih simple. Okay?
So,
okay, let's do it.
Let's do it. So instead of putting it like this, another way of doing it is, for example, we can
output
equal. For example, we can say, this.
Okay.
If
it's too fast.
It's too fast. Else
00 00.
Okay, yes.
Lebih simple kan kayak gitu.
And then here we need to do is to print output.
Yep, kita taruh print output di sini, kita delete, lalu di sini kita delete. Okay, lebih simple kan sekarang code-nya. Nah, tapi di sini tuh mungkin cara penulisannya memang agak beda, yang dimana lebih bagus, lebih cantik kelihatannya, lebih simple. Okay, kita lihat.
Yeah, so it is the same thing.
Ini masih sama, ya. Jadi udah pasti ini sukses kembali.
And then if this is clear, yes, then we can.
Yay!
And then we can make it even more simple. We can just take this and put it
output.
Here.
Wow.
So output,
kita
right?
Delete deh outputnya. Sekarang lebih simple kan?
So look how simple it is. This is just a comment. And voila, so basically all this is two lines only. The rest already came from them, from Coding Game, yes? We wrote only these two lines. Let's see if it works again. Looks, it's working. The speed is always around 40.
Yeah! Okay, jadi kayak gini lebih simple, lebih asik, dan lebih enak dilihat gitu ya. Kalau tadi kan ada 4 baris, tapi sekarang kita bisa membuatnya lebih simple, jadi cuma 2 baris pada akhirnya.
Perfect.
Okay.
So we just submit.
Ya, kita bisa langsung submit aja. Kalau misalnya udah nggak ada yang harus dilakukan, kita tinggal submit. Okay. Yay! 100. Okay.
Wonderful.
Publish. Publish, kita bisa publish.
Oh. It's not publishing. Okay, we published it.
Okay. Okay, nah di sini kalian bisa lihat my solution. Nah, jangan lupa setiap kali kalian lihat solusi aku, kalian bisa kasih upvote.
If you like it, upvote. I think it's quite simple and clear, right? So
yes.
If you find something better, of course, I'll do that. Okay.
Okay. Okay, so, sampai sini aja dulu ya video untuk kali ini. Aku harap kalian ngerti sekarang, dan buat kalian yang main C# juga pasti kalau kalian ketemu Python ngerasa, oh kayaknya ini sama deh kayak kemarin gitu ya. Okay.
Bye. To the next one.
Sampai jumpa di video selanjutnya. Bye-bye.